Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Coding Card. So today we'll try to solve one hacker rank problem from the topic strings in Python. Here the problem name is alphabet rangoli. So let us go through the problem. Here the problem states that you are given an integer n and your task is to print an alphabet rangoli of size n. So for example, you can see here for size equal to 3, the rangoli seems like this. Means they are picking only 3 character A, B, C to generate this rangoli. For size equal to 5, they have picked 5 character A, B, C, D, E to generate this rangoli. Similarly, for size equal to 10, they are taking the character from A to J. So here the constant is n value will be greater than 0 and less than 27, means total 27 characters. So we have to complete this print rangoli function. So they are providing the size. Size is this n value. So we have to build the logic to get this rangoli. So looking this output, you can see here, just see this first line. For size equal to 3, means the third element is ABC, the third element is C. So the very first line they have printed C. So if you look at this whole output, you can see here, for each and every line the width size is fixed. Now if my width size is fixed, so if I simply apply a center function with this string, the output will be this one, the very first line. So again, for size equal to 5, you can see here my fifth character is E, and if I simply apply a center function with a fixed width size and the filling character is this hyphen, so the very first line will look like this one. But the task is how to get this width size. So if you look in middle, this middle string, for every example you can see here this middle one, and also for size equal to 10 this middle line, if I will get this string length, this middle string length, then that will be my width size. So our task is to first get this width size. So we have to first generate this string, and we'll simply take the length of this middle string to generate the width size for the whole iteration. So let us do a stepwise. So our very first task is to take the 27 characters. So for that we'll simply use a range function, from 97 to 123. So and we'll simply convert this into character type with the help of map function. And after this we'll simply convert it into a list. So we are done with the 27 character list. Let me name it as a L1. Now we are done with the 27 characters. Now we will pick the character from this L1. Now the very first task is to generate this string so that we can get the fixed width size. So how to generate this width, this string? So for n equal to 5, this middle string is this one. So let me explain here. For n equal to 5, my total character will be picked from L1 having value A to Z. So for n equal to 5, the total character will be A, B, C, D and E. So with the help of these 5 character, we have to build this string, this one. So that string is A, B, C, D and E. A, B, C, D, E and in reverse order. This is the string, and hyphen is been attached in every between each and every character. So we will simply apply that later on. So first of all, we will generate this string. So let us divide it into two parts. From here to here, first part, from here to here second part. So you, if you see here, this is like taking the value from 0 to n and in a reverse order. So if I write this one, to get this string, if I write this is L1, if I take the value from, this is having value A, B, C, D, E, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it is taking the value from 4, means n minus 1 is to last, n minus 1 is to last. So we'll simply leave that and taking the value in reverse order, minus 1. So it will give the first part, and for the second part, if I simply write from 1 is to last, means n value, n is here 5, so it will take up to 4 only. So till 4 it is having value e. So we are done with this string, and if I simply add this one, let me save this in a x. Now I have another list x having value this one. So x is having value from e, d, c, b, a, and b, c, d, e. Now if I simply join this x with a hyphen to generate, so if I simply join, use a join function with this hyphen, so it will simply generate a string like this one. So let us write that code. The very first task is to generate the string. So for that I will simply take, I will apply the same logic from n minus 1 to last in a reverse order. So first part is done, and for the second part I will take value from 1 is to n. So let me save this in a x. So x is having value e, d, c, b, a, b, c, d, e. Now this is a list. Now I will simply apply a join function with a hyphen dot join function to generate that string, and I will simply pass this x. Now string has been generated. I will simply apply a length function to get this length. Now let me save that length in variable m. Now this is our fixed width size. For n equal to 5, this fixed width size for each iteration is fixed. So that value is m. Now we are done with the half part. Now let us divide this problem in two parts, from here to here first part, and from this middle to last second part. So let us work on the first part. Let me explain you here. If you see the output for the first part, I'm taking the upper part as a first part till this one. In this one I am taking the first part, from here to here. So the string will look like D, E, D, E, D, E, so it will look like this one, CD. So the very first upper part, just focus on this character value. So it looks like this. So if we get this character, we'll simply apply the join method with a hyphen to generate the string, and simply apply a center function. So now how to get these characters? Now let me divide these in a simple way. If I divide this like this one, so you can see here, for this if I simply write a logic n minus 1 is 2 a b c d e 0 1 2 3 4 and my n value is 5. Now to get this character, if I simply write n minus 1 means 4 is 2 n value, then it will generate and give me a value e. Now for this, if I simply write n minus 2 is 2 n, it will give me n minus 2 is value 5 minus 2 3, from 3 is to 5, so it will give d and d. For this, if I write the n minus 3 is to n, so it will give the value from c to e. Similarly, if I write n minus 4 is to n, it will give me value from b to e. So seems like in a general formula, if I write n minus I is to n, if I pick value from l1, n minus I is to n, and I is having value from n, I is having value from I equal to 1. So I'm done with this part. So let us generate this second part. So let us go from the last. So it is having value C, D and E. So how to get this one? So for E, if I write n minus 1 is 2 C. C is having value how much? 2, means n minus 4. If I write n minus 4, so n minus 4 will be not n minus 4, yes, n minus 4, cause 4 is not excluded, means n minus 4 having value, this will be 4 is to 1. So 4 is to 1 means it will take the value from e to, not it will exclude this 1, means e to c. So e to c in a reverse order, minus 1. So this will work for this one. Similarly, if I build the logic from n minus 1, this e is fixed, so n minus 1 is 2 d, we have to take the value e and d, so we have to take up to here, so n minus 3, n minus 3 will be 2, n minus 3 will be 2, means it will exclude 2, so we will get value only d and e in a reverse order. And for this, again we will simply apply, you can see here the like sequence, you can see here a pattern is being formed, n minus 1 is 2, n minus 2 is 2 minus 1 in a reverse order. So e n minus 2 will be having value 3, so it will only take e, it will exclude this one. And for this one, only space is there, you can see here space is here. If I build a logic like n minus 1 is 2, n minus 1 is 2 minus 1, so it will take the value 4 is 2, n minus 1 will be 4 in a reverse order, so it will pick value nothing, so it will be space over here. So this is working. So its general formula will be n minus 1 is to n minus I in a reverse order. So this will be the general formula. So let us apply this logic over here. So let us first, I am applying this logic for the first part, and similarly we'll just apply the logic in a reverse order for the second part. So for I in range 1 to m, as I is from, you can see here I is from 1 to n. Let me assign this size in n, so we don't need to write size each and every time. Now we'll simply print first, we will take the L1 and L2 value. L1, now I have to apply this formula. I will simply write this formula, n minus 1 is to n minus I in reverse order minus 1. So this is the first string. For the second, we will simply take L1, now n minus I till n. Now we are done. We will simply apply a join function to add this hyphen between the characters. So we'll simply apply a join function with a hyphen. So this will simply join the characters. Now you can see here, for the very first we will get only E. Now we got the E. Now after this we will simply apply a center function with the fixed width, and the width size is M, and my filling character is hyphen. Let us execute this one for the very first part. So you can see here it is generating the value as expected for the first part, first upper part. It is working fine. Now we'll simply apply the same logic for the lower part, but in a reverse order. Simply copy and paste the same logic, but here we have to take the value from, if you see here, we have to take the value from n equal to, from e, it is taking the value e to a, means n minus 1 is to n minus 1. Not n minus 1, from n to last 0 in a reverse order. Let us run this code. So you can see here it is working fine. So the task was only to first build the logic for the upper part, and for the lower part we'll simply apply the logic in a reverse order. Let us run this code. So you can see here we're generating the same output. Let us submit this one. So congratulations, we are done with the all the hidden test cases. So it's a quite interesting problem in which we have simply done this with the help of part wise. The first part was to build this a list of character, then how to generate this a fixed width size, and simply we have distributed this into two part, upper part and the lower part. So the task was to first generate this upper part, and for the lower part we have simply applied the same logic in a reverse order, from n equal to I equal to from n to 0 in a reverse order. So if you like this video, please do give thumbs up and don't forget to hit the bell icon and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.